I have been an activist working on gun violence prevention for almost 20 years. I got involved after the Columbine High School massacre. So my teacher, Dave Sanders, was a teacher, a basketball coach and typing teacher, and he died in that massacre. And I remember sitting at his funeral and thought, this is ridiculous. And I wanted to get involved. And so that's what I did. And I wrote a book. I was really interested in telling the stories of people who were impacted. And so I wrote a book about 19 people who either lost a loved one to gun violence or were shot and survived. And then I was really interested in telling another side of the story, the side of the shooters.
I was arrested as a young teenager, for murder. I went to jail for 10 to 20 years. I decided to change my life when my son was born after 9 months. And I knew that I really had to work on myself in order to be a father to him because I didn't have a father myself. So when I was in prison, I just started just opening my mind up to new approaches to things in life and dealing with my anger and my emotions. I started studying myself. I started studying human behavior. And I started mentoring other young men in prison with me. I was released in 1998, and when I came home, it's something I wanted to give back to the community. I wanted to give back, clean up my dirt, and give back to young men and women who had the same dilemma as I had. So eventually I became a mentor and a community activist. And 2014, when me and Heidi met, I went to the Washington Monument with a group of activists, and I spoke at the Washington Monument, and I told my story. It was a bunch of women there who actually lost children to violence. So I was the only one there who was actually the victimizer, and not a victim of violence. And I just told my story and what I've done with my life and how I'm giving back to the community. And me and Heidi met that day, and we talked, and now we're here.
So I love writing, and I loved the process of writing the book called Beyond the Bullet. And I loved that process. Wanted to write a second book about this subject, but I thought that the medium of a book wasn't going to work as well, and I thought a film would be better. And the reason is there's a guy who's in the film, Kevin, who shot an intruder in his home, and he had every right to do so. Someone was in his house. He felt unsafe and like his life was in jeopardy. So he shot the guy and killed him. And when he ended up not getting arrested, he feels like it was great. Like, hey, I did this. It was my legal right. But then what happened is there's a cost that's happened, and he's paranoid. He has a hard time sleeping. And that didn't show up in his words, it shows up in his face, the complexity and how he's torn between, I did what I had to do to save my family, but I don't feel good about what I did because I took a life. That I would have never been able to capture that if it was in a book, but in a film, it was.
The reality is understanding having the right mentality behind the gun, behind the bullet. And that's the biggest problem that we have today. So this film brings that awareness. Do you have the right mentality to carry a gun? Not just being safe, or if you're too afraid to carry a gun, hey, you walk down the street, or you encounter somebody because their music up too loud, and now you have a gun, so now you have heart to challenge them. I mean, so it kind of looks at the brain, the mindset of a person who's really carrying these guns, these weapons around. And hopefully bring some awareness to them and make them think twice before they pull that trigger.
And so one thing that really surprised me is I thought that once somebody died that you knew from a gun, that you would become anti-gun. And that is not the case. It's a very complex issue. There's a boy in the film who killed he was 8 years old. He found the mom's gun and he killed his 5-year-old brother accidentally. And that family is in North Carolina, and their religion and their gun culture is very tied together. And it ends up, and I show the complexity of that and how that because a son died doesn't mean that they just all automatically got rid of their guns. It's very complex, and they're trying to live and deal with the sadness and the loss and the shame and the guilt, and it's all mixed together.